Google have finally introduced a timeline view in Google Sheets. In today's video, we're going to give you a brief overview of what that means and how to start using it. So if you're new here, welcome to Keep Productive. We cover productivity tools, especially Google ones. So do make sure you're subscribed and check out Tool Finder if you're currently looking for a productivity tool. So here we are with the example that I've created for the timeline view. And very simply, this is a way to visualize anything with dates. So here I have some mock data that I've put in of a few key dates with a start date and an end date. Now what I can do, and just before we begin, you need a certain access to certain accounts for this. I will list them on the screen now to give you an idea of what account access you need. I think I'm using the standard business account, so do make sure that you cannot use this on the personal account. I believe you can use it on essentials, however. I'll link that below. So the way you do this is go to Insert and press Timeline. Now this new timeline view basically takes your data and essentially projects it into a new view that you can see down at the bottom in this page. And you can see here, quite interestingly, it's done it fairly easy. You can actually modify the date range from here, choose which is a start and end date, and actually have the card title as a different thing. Now you can change the card color, the card details as the information behind it. For example, if you had a data behind it, for example, you calculate another page, then that's something you can bring up next to it. And you can group them by column as well. So you can see here that this gives you a bit more window into if you had subtasks beneath it as well. So what's nice is you can modify this based on week. You can see this in a condensed or a comfortable view. Condensed is a little bit more fine-tuned, and you can choose the zooming in and out rate. You can go much closer if you want to, or in the middle ground. And you can knock settings off if you want over here. So this is very simple. You can actually click into each one and edit the color of stuff. So for example, if I click into this one and I choose a different color, you can have that selected. And that gives it a little bit of a pop when you're using it here. So you can see all the information in the card detail, and you can even customize this color using hex codes as well. So that's something that's really nice. So down here, you can see and rename this, and you can also protect the color of it. And naturally, I can give it a new name like timeline view for this. And every time you create a timeline on a piece of data, it creates a new view for that, which is really decent. If you're ever scrobbling ahead and you're looking at a date in the future, I was remembering you should be able to press today, but doesn't seem to be working. But that's one of the things you can do, and I used previously as well. I can go and edit the data from the source if I want to, if it's a little bit complicated to find it. I've got large spews of this information. And this is something that is really nice. Now, the only thing I can't seem to be able to do is being able to modify the length of it, which is something you cannot do in Timeline View. This is much more of an end experience, perfect for sending on to clients and third parties. So folks, hopefully you found this video useful about Google Sheets timeline. Let us know what you think below. And if you're looking for a productivity tool in the space right now, feel free to check out Tool Finder, which will be linked below. Thank you very much, folks, and I'll see you again in a future video. Cheerio.